Time now for French Connections, our weekly look at the intricacies of life here in France. Good to see you, Flo. Today we're going to be jumping on board an institution in this country, and that's, of course, the TGV, France's version of the bullet train.
That's right. It's our acronym du jour, the TGV, the Train à Grande Vitesse, France's intercity high-speed rail service operated by the SNCF. That is going to be another acronym du jour. So the SNCF is the Société Nationale des Chemins de Fer Français. Now, the first voyage of the TGV was inaugurated by President François Mitterrand. This was in September 1981. And fun fact, the very first train was called Patrick, after the name of the son of the very first train conductor. Now, with a line speed of over 270 kilometers an hour, the flashy orange train was a symbol of the country's engineering prowess, but it was much more than just an industrial feat. It also really revolutionized modern train travel and completely decentralized France. Far-flung cities were now just a few hours away instead of requiring a day trip or even sometimes a night trip. And I love these old photos. You can see people smoking in the trains, which is incredible. But it really revolutionized travel in France.
C'est un train qui a permis d'abolir les distances et le temps, puisque ça a permis, la vitesse a fait gagner du temps aux gens. Et c'est vrai que l'arrivée du TGV a permis de rétrécir le territoire petit à petit.
Je l'ai pris pour la première fois en 1988, avec mes parents, de Lyon à Paris.
Moi, j'en garde un très bon souvenir, puisque c'est extrêmement rapide.
Now, in the past four decades, the TGV has transported some 3 billion passengers over the years. The network has expanded across the country.
That's right. Now, it is centered on Paris, but the TGV network does connect some 230 destinations, making it really easy to crisscross across the country. Now, these days, trains typically operate at 320 kilometers an hour. That's 200 miles per hour, which means it's often faster and more convenient than, for instance, a drive or taking the plane. Now, for instance, if you're traveling between Paris and Marseille, so the capital and the southern town, that's 850 kilometers. Well, it only takes a little over 3 hours on the TGV. Now, all this means it's a very popular network that carries about 110 million passengers a year.
But the TGV doesn't only have fans, however.
Absolutely. Critics say that France's infatuation with the TGV means that some smaller lines, some more regional lines, have been neglected. These lines that keep countless smaller villages alive, well, they've been a little bit neglected, perhaps, by the TGV, which means that there's been a certain desertification of the country. And another complaint that comes up a lot is that even though the TGV service is very practical, it's also quite expensive. And it's not always clear why it's so expensive. Take a listen.
C'est un manque de transparence. Donc du coup, on s'y perd un petit peu. Si c'était clair et transparent et qu'on comprenait le système, ça me poserait pas de problème.
Malheureusement, c'est extrêmement difficile de percevoir un prix réel et accessible du train.
Now, Flo, though it can be quite pricey to travel by TGV, it certainly is better for the environment.
It certainly is. If you travel by TGV, you'll pollute 50 times less than if you take a car and 80 times less than if you take a plane. And some passengers say that the environmental impact is something that they really take into account when they're planning their trip.
Je ne prends jamais l'avion pour aller à Paris, je viens de Bordeaux, parce que je trouve que le train c'est plus écologique.
Moi je pense qu'on pollue.
Quand on
prend le
train. Ah oui. Oh, moi je trouve que c'est moins polluant en tout cas.
Que les voitures, oui.
L'avion, etc. Hein.
Now TGVs of the future promise to be even less polluting.
Greener and more comfortable, Delano. Recently, the French president Emmanuel Macron unveiled a mock-up of the next generation, which is called the TGVM. So this streamlined version of the bullet trains promises to carry more passengers, up to 740 passengers from currently 600, using 20% less electricity. It'll be decked out with high-speed internet, also a two-story bar car, which sounds very exciting. And these modern trains are planned to enter service in 2024. The question is, though, will they be enough to keep the SNCF on track because France's state-owned rail service is currently riddled with a lot of debt, partially due to its investment in the TGV lines. And on top of that, it's now facing competition from foreign and private enterprises. So the question is, will passengers, will they be somewhat unfaithful to the SNCF, or will they remain very faithful to the SNCF? That is still quite debatable.
Je prendrai le moins cher et le plus pratique.
Et le moins cher?
Je pense que je vais regarder tout, quoi. Je vais me renseigner. C'est ça le but du jeu.
Je suis assez fidèle quand même à la SNCF, mais après, pourquoi pas?
Je regarderai d'abord la SNCF. Si, aux horaires et par rapport au prix, il y a quelque chose d'autre, pourquoi pas?
So before we go, just a little bit of TGV trivia for your next pub quiz, Delano. The TGV trains that are made by Alstom have been exported to other countries, for instance, Spain, Italy, South Korea, Morocco, and the United States. And another very important thing, the TGV set the world record for the fastest wheeled train. This was in April 2007. It went up to 574.8 kilometers an hour. So that was something that the French are very proud of, as you can imagine.
So I will definitely use that as a fun fact. Thank you very much for that, Florence Villemino there. That's all we have time for in this edition of French Connections. But in the meantime, you can tweet your questions to Flo. The address is at Flo Villemino, and you can check out our website, france24.com. That's it for this edition of Life in Paris. From all of us on the team, thank you very much for watching.